Hi, it's Miss Campos. Today's lesson is about primary colors. We will be looking at the artist Piet Mondrian, and we will be creating a composition using those primary colors, red, blue, and yellow. The objective for today. You'll be able to identify primary colors. Given flashcards or colored supplies like bottle caps, construction papers, or markers, you will be able to sort them by color with at least 80% accuracy. Mondrian. The primary colors are red, yellow, and blue. Broadway Boogie Woogie by Piet Mondrian. The painting was completed in 1943 after Piet Mondrian moved to New York in 1940. He saw lots of cars and buildings on Broadway, a street in New York. He created a painting with all of these squares and rectangles to represent this lively Manhattan street. Broadway Boogie Woogie was a type of music that Mondrian really liked, and it was loud and had lots of instruments playing at the same time, like the sound of busy Broadway. What types of lines does Mondrian use? He uses lines that are vertical, that means they go up and down, and horizontal, that means they go straight across. Some are thin, some are thick. What types of shapes does he use? He uses squares and rectangles. Some are thinner than others, some are thicker than others, some are smaller. What you will need to create your own Piet Mondrian inspired artwork. Any size white paper, red, blue, and yellow construction paper, scissors, and glue.
Hi, this is Ms. Campos, and today we're going to be looking at primary colors. What are primary colors? Primary colors are red, blue, and yellow. You can mix primary colors to make secondary colors, and we'll talk more about that when we talk about secondary colors, but no colors can mix to make these colors. So, we're looking at the artist Piet Mondrian. He's a Dutch painter, and he created Broadway Boogie Woogie. And we're going to make our own Broadway Boogie Woogie inspired artwork, but we need to learn a couple of things about how he created his picture. So he used lines. So he used thin lines and thick lines and some vertical lines, like when we do rub, rub. We talk about vertical lines. Vertical lines are lines that go straight up and down. Horizontal lines are lines that go straight across. He used some shapes. He used squares and rectangles. And his lines and squares and rectangles, some of them are apart. Some of them are right next to each other. And some of them are overlapping. That means there's a shape or a line that's right over the other. And there's also rhythm in his paintings. Like in music, we can read this like a sheet of music. So we have a big rectangle of blue followed by two squares. So if we're going to read this like music students, we can go blue, red, red, yellow, red, red, blue, red, blue, yellow, yellow. So there's a rhythm, there's a pace. So when you look at his painting, we could also look at that kind of pace and that kind of rhythm, and we could even clap it out. So if we were to clap it out, we would go blue, red, red, yellow, red, red, blue, red, blue, yellow, yellow. So there's some beats to this painting. So, a couple things that we need to get started. a sheet of white paper, red paper, blue, and yellow paper, some scissors, and I think we're all set to get started. So here I have some strips of paper, and this is a pretty thick line, but if I wanted to make it even thinner, I can cut it in half, I can make thin lines. So I'm gonna use some thin lines, glue it onto my paper. And I can decide, is it gonna go straight up and down, a vertical line, straight across, a horizontal line? I can decide. I'm gonna use a thicker line now. So right now I have a thin yellow line that goes up and down, and I have a thick blue line that goes across, and a thin line that goes across over here. Now let's see what else I can add. I need some red, because right now I have blue and yellow. I need another primary color in here, the red. And I can have some of these lines overlap. That means they go right on top. And I can also, with this strip, cut small squares. I'm gonna put some squares in my picture. And I can even put some smaller squares inside of other lines or inside of these other squares. So I'm gonna put a yellow inside of this blue box. So I can show you. I put a square here and then of blue, but then I put another rectangle inside of my blue square. You can totally do that. And I also want to put some rectangles on my line, the large rectangle. So let me show you. So I have this line here, but I decided to put some rectangles inside there too. And you can decide when you're done with this. You can keep adding and adding and overlapping. And here's one that I worked on earlier. So you see a lot of boxes, some things inside, other things, some lines intersecting, overlapping. And here's another one that's all done. So I can't wait to see what your projects look like. Now remember, you can make it like Miss Campos made it with construction paper. You can also color it in if you don't have construction paper. Or you can take pictures of objects, toys, things in your house that are red, blue, and yellow. So many different ways for you to do this project. I can't wait to see what you come up with. Bye!
Here are some student works. So you can do your Piet Mondrian inspired artwork in many different ways. You can put those lines overlapping next to each other, many different ways. Don't forget to take a picture of your work and submit it to your Google Classroom. I hope you had fun.